Zendaya, who is this gorgeously tailored suit. I do really admire him. I think he's built a really interesting fashion line. And I think his tastes and what he pulls in is so American. Like, he's like, to me, when I think of American fashion, I think of Ralph Lauren. And I'm not mad about it. Some more table of contents. Another watch that I don't know about. Here's the editor's letter. Now you see me. I can't really tell if that has a theme, but thank you, editor, for putting together this magazine. It's a brand that I know has very, very rich people, subtle clothing. So here's their credits, you know, who worked on the magazine. Love to see it. And a chin ad. So here we have a little pre-Q&A with Regina King. She directed her debut film, One Night in Miami. Should we, we'll read a little bit about what she said in the questions. What's one thing this year has taught you? That you can never be too prepared. What's the one thing you're most looking forward to doing when the pandemic is over? Going to see Tank and the Bongas in concert. What's the one trait you consider essential to your success? I guess sincerity. Honesty. Sometimes I'm brutally honest, and people have called it abrasive, but I call it saving time. What's the one thing you always have with you on set? Water. Okay, we'll stop there. She seems lovely. I am a fan of Regina King. I love the movie she was in, Support the Girls. It was like a smaller movie. She was so good. Okay. So this is where Wall Street Journal asks six luminaries to weigh in on a topic. The topic they gave them was anticipation. So they had these six people write about anticipation, including Cassie David, which is funny to me. Tucson, Arizona. Okay. Oh, fun. Because it was December, we're gonna get a gift guide. I loved gift guides because I love to say I would like this as a gift or not. Sorry, bumped the camera. So, gift guide. They have this Louis Vuitton bag that's like a retro bag. Pass, not for me. Let's see. Handmade quilts and blankets. Sure. I was like a blanket. Pretty. This is a jewelry box of vintage jewelry. Obviously vintage was a trend. And like, of course, that's gorgeous. That's gorgeous. You know? That's gorgeous. This is a wooden stool with a rough upholstery. Yeah, I actually could make that work. Really cool. Here's a watch. Not for me. I'm not a purse girl. I'm not a watch girl. Here we have a Chanel ad for Bleu de Chanel. Discover the parfum. Is this a men's cologne? Or, because it says parfum, which would make me think it's for women. Maybe it's unisex. Maybe I don't need the binary. Pretty branding though. Okay, back to our gift guide. We have this clay bowl or container. Yeah, that's gorgeous. I love that. apples and a nutcracker. Pass. I don't think I use a nutcracker enough to really need to own one. And the bowls just don't quite match my kitchen. Okay, what's news? Fairy tale. So this is about the Manhattan ferry terminal getting turned into a hotel, a club, and event space. Serum that's $120. This is about a flat in Paris that's for rent, a clay sculpture, and a watch. Here we have Jen Atkin, the hairstylist. She's the hairstylist for the Kardashians, and she founded the hair care brand OY. I'm not sure that's how you say it, but it's very popular. This is her doing the download the what's on her phone. So they ask questions about it. Let's read. How many unread emails? 0. I open every email immediately. Biggest time-wasting app? TikTok. Last app that you check at night? My calendar to make sure I'm all set for tomorrow. The person you FaceTime the most? My husband or Chrissy Teigen. That's funny. Most recent Uber ride? From my sister's house in Utah to the airport. $40 for the 16-mile from my hometown to the new one. Most surprising app, Trello and Beekeeper. Okay, I think those are both productivity apps. Times you're off the phone. I try to be off the phone when I'm with friends and family, and I keep my phone in another room when I sleep. Best tweet of the week you've read. She's quoting it here. You never realize how many people you hate until you think of baby names. The most used entertainment app, Audible. Her favorite Instagram feeds. She names a bunch. I think that's where we'll stop on that. Kind of a fun segment though. And then here's some gear for winter. Puffy coat and the likes. This is an advertisement for Samsung and their healthcare products. So this is about a new fashion line, and this is about a new picture book. Also highlighting this new jewelry line. Okay, of these, what do we like best? What do you like best? I think I like this brooch best. That's because I don't really like the colors in a lot of these other ones for my personal wardrobe. But just like thinking of what's so beautiful, I do think those are very beautiful. Okay, and some furniture. Sitting in it, to be honest. That's my recap. Oh, and I don't like that one. Here's a light fixture that I don't feel sure of. And this is something about caviar. I don't think I've ever eaten caviar, so can't weigh in on that. Here we have Harry Winston jewelry. Pretty, but again, not really my color. This is a jewelry report. So we have this beautiful necklace and ring. Pretty. Here's an earring with this gorgeous profile shot. This necklace with a really weird shot. Here we have this kind of collar necklace and bracelet. I'm not really loving those. They are he was working on a collection with Louis Vuitton. This is his point of view with this gorgeous photo of a garden. I love this garden. And it's an interview of the Constant Gardener with landscape and garden designer Luciano Giabielli. That's probably not how you say that. Sorry, Italians. I assume it's Italian. I can't say her name, but I love your gardens. Look how beautiful. So this is in Majorca, it seems. And this home decor style, though very minimal, feels very beautiful and friendly still. Outdoor seating area. Love. This just feels like a place you would want to be, you know? Some more interior design. Beautiful staircase. The lighting on that is gorgeous. Again, very minimal, but still friendly. These feel a little less friendly. Speaking.